And discussion and consideration of new personnel hire. We had talked about this at the workshop, about trying to get Mr. Housewright some help because of the shortage of our chief financial officer being out. So we still don't know exactly when she might be coming back, so.
And it's not just for Mr. Housewright, it's
For the city.
Office too.
Well, it's for the city.
And the city too, because the office has just covered up the two girls, a part-time and a full-time, trying to do two people's jobs. Mike's doing three people's jobs.
Mike's young enough, he can handle that just as well.
Well, I think it's a disservice.
I think that we need to go ahead and let him hire somebody.
Well, if I may speak to the subject, Tammy came by City Hall today, so she's out. Like was previously stated, she is looking at four additional weeks off. That's the minimum. We know that she will not return before that time. I would like to go ahead and ask the board to approve temporary personnel. But quite frankly, I'd like to go ahead, get everything lined up, get things ready to roll. But if we're looking at her return in 4 weeks, or her possible return, I'd like to hold off on actually making that hire. Because by the time we found somebody, went through the process, interviewed, we're probably looking at 3 weeks. And frankly, that just pulls time for me to engage in that process. It pulls time away from endeavors that I need to be engaged in anyway. So if she does return in 4 weeks, then I would not bring anybody in. But I would like to go ahead and prepare so that if she is unable to return in 4 weeks, then we need to go ahead and pull the trigger and bring somebody in as quickly as possible.
So what do you want to do? You want to table that for a while?
I would like to go ahead and get the okay to do it. But I'll tell you that I will not do it until we hear back from Tammy in 4 weeks as to whether she can return.
I just have a question on that. If you get the okay, then you've got somebody hired that's going to come in for 4 weeks. At the end of 4 weeks, what happens? If when Tammy comes back, you're going to lay her off? Lay him or her off?
Well, anybody that we bring in will be on a temporary basis. Now, we don't know when Tammy will return, and we don't know what kind of restrictions that she may have when she does return. She may be allowed to return at the end of this 4 weeks with limited time. She may be unable to do a 40-hour week. So if she does return on a restricted basis, then likely she will need some help getting caught up as well. But ultimately, the person that we look for in the short term would be temporary. And they would step into the position knowing that it's temporary. So they would be the expectation that this would turn into a full-time position for them. But likewise, Coach Trains, she did reassure me and encouraged me to encourage the board that, yes, in 2 years' time, she is retiring. And that we
she
need,
has to train.
We need to be looking in that direction. But right now, I think our biggest need is preparing for a short-term person, temporary, to help me and possibly when she returns, to help her get caught up. And it very well may be that when Tammy returns, she doesn't want any help. Finance officers are a particular person. Sometimes they don't like other people mucking about in their books. So it may be that when she returns, she doesn't want
that's
any help.
Well, I don't mind going with temporary help, but I'd like to get a time element in there somewhere.
So you're saying you want the okay to do it, but you're gonna wait 4 weeks anyway?
Right.
And we're gonna be back here in 4 weeks, don't we just postpone this?
Well, it's been about a week and a half.
Doesn't have to be 2 weeks.
And that would be fine. The only problem is, it's been about a week and a half that Tammy's been, so we're realistically looking at 2.5 weeks.
Okay.
Before we know something, so.
She goes back to the doctor the 30th, she told me.
Yeah. The 30th. So we could, if it's the 30th that she will know, then we could revisit this in March. But I do need to be preparing, because if that happens and she's unable to return at that time, then I need to pull the trigger quickly and get somebody in here.
They have to be, you're gonna look for somebody that's got the certification too, don't you? Aren't you?
They don't have to be certified. Well, what I need, and more than likely, anybody with the skill set will have a CMFO certification, or will have had it in the past. What we need is someone with that skill set and ability to do the job.
Already experienced, that's what you're saying.
Right. Tammy is still our CMFO, as far as the state is concerned, and that is sufficient. And likewise, if we do hire somebody, it'd be great if we can get someone with that certification. However, if we can find somebody with that skill set, the state allows for 2 years of a grace period while they seek that certification.
So, why don't we discuss that at the workshop? We have a workshop coming up in like 2 weeks. Can we do it that way?
We can do that.
Only I say on that, we're kind of looking for, do we need to fill with somebody to fill in? I know this always on what Tammy's gonna do.
Yeah.
Right. We don't know that at this point.
Maybe if we wait till next month, we'll know whether we want somebody in that's gonna be long-term for the training under her and taking over instead of just a temporary.
It could be. And I can look at both. The big thing is if she is returning in 4 weeks, then I don't particularly want to spend a lot of time that I don't already have available trying to find somebody.
Or train someone. By the time you got a train, she'd be fine. Mm-hmm.
Makes sense.
So everybody,
it's 22.
Is in agreement to kind of table this for the workshop?
You don't need to vote on it.
No.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.